The Premier has abandoned a news conference in Bendigo after protesters gatecrashed a TAFE opening. It's the latest escalation in tensions around the pandemic bill, with two prominent health chiefs also copping a spray. More from Stephanie Anderson.
Making an early exit from his own media call, the Premier ambushed in Bendigo, where he'd travelled to open a TAFE, an announcement drowned out by calls to kill the bill.
And to perhaps give you a quieter time, I'm going to go now.
The fury around pandemic laws has spilled well beyond Spring Street, but on Monday, that's where the health chief and COVID commander needed a police escort to safely leave Parliament.
Scumbags! It's what the public really thinks of you.
People just need to get a grip.
The same steps played host to a rally last night, a crowd gathering to hear from Upper House MPs who'll have the legislation on their agenda when Parliament sits next week.
It's not just! It's not just!
Andrews and his government want even more power.
You've seen some pretty crude examples of opposition MPs aligning themselves with pretty interesting types.
David certainly is entitled to get up and put the opposition's point of view around the most dangerous piece of legislation to hit the Victorian Parliament.
Just because a law gives certain powers doesn't mean those powers can be exercised tomorrow. This bill is a significant improvement on the current legislation.
The three crossbenchers, key to whether it passes or fails, are also targets for threats and abuse. This letter sent to Justice Party MP Andy Medic had a used condom enclosed.
I think much of it is the result of a deliberate campaign of misinformation that's being peddled by others.
People have got to get their frustrations and take them out at the ballot box. That's the democratic way.
But as many focus on the politics ahead, it's the past that the opposition wants revisited, calling on Victoria Police to reopen its Red Shirts investigation in the wake of Adam Somurek's IBAC evidence.
Well, it's been investigated more often than the Kennedy assassination. I'm not in the business of telling Victoria Police what they should or shouldn't do.
Steph, following today's incident, will the Premier's security be beefed up?
Well, Pete, my understanding is there won't be any ongoing consequences or changes as a result of today's pretty extraordinary encounter for Daniel Andrews. I also understand, though, that his decision to leave that location well ahead of schedule was a direct result of police advice to do so because tensions were escalating pretty quickly. As for any further information or details about how this may change the way he moves around the state,